Hello and welcome to another evening of sculpting. Tonight I'm going to be working on this Veteran Kazak for Infinity the Game, and I am working on, I'm going to need to work on resculpting a lot of this detail along this shoulder here, in the back. He has a backpack, so I also need to be aware of that. So I'll be test fitting that back and forth. But basically just going to be taking kind of this neck detail here, wrapping it back around, and then doing the straps for his backpack as they come around, which they've been completely shaped off. I'll also need to work on the shotgun itself. This is just a little bit of sprue that I have used and just basically sanded into shape. But I'm going to need to add a little more detail to get it to match this gun, which is a little difficult to see because it's a little easier. It's primed black, but... So, basically just trying to get the shotgun to match that gun. Or, you know, close to. And I also have just another Veteran Kazak in case I get kind of... lost in what I'm doing, so I can look back and say, okay, that's what I need to do now. But that said, it should be fairly quick. I'm thinking shouldn't be more than maybe 3 sessions, but even that seems like a lot. So we're gonna just go ahead and see what I can do. And I'm gonna go ahead and mix up some green stuff. Some things so I can use up some of those tires. Right now I'm just basically getting all the shapes kind of volumed out. And doing a little bit of detailing, but not anything too fine yet. so I'll need to do this strap here. It needs to go there. I think I'm going to hold off on that because I don't want... I think this work actually looks pretty good. It's nice and clean, very simple. And I don't want to mess it up but just by trying to add more detail before this is set. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just work a little bit on this shotgun, adding a little more detail. I think one of the things I'm going to need to do is bulk this part out a little bit so that I can kind of add this this little, I guess it would be where the casing ejects. I don't know. Anyways, that little bit of detail I need to add. So... take a little bit. I think I'm the blue. I try to get some fine detail in there whenever I can. Now I think this opposite side is luckily going to be right up against this chest, so I hopefully won't have to do as much detail, but I'm going to have to do a little bit just so it doesn't look too weird, but I think some of the detail I can kind of fudge on this other side. So I'm going to focus on this front side first. I'm going to really try and get it detailed without making it too fat. Because that's the other thing is, really these guns don't have a lot of thickness to them. And I'm trying to, something that's kind of hard to avoid when you're hand sculpting. Especially when there's detail that's like indented in like this the round ejector or the ejector port. So before I put any detail in this, I think what I want to do is just get a little bit of green stuff, put it right in here just to kind of connect those 2 points. As you can see here, it's just not really that light between those 2 bits, and I think that'll help me out ultimately, just to have that connected. It's not going to be a perfect one-to-one replica, or, you know, recreation, but I think it'll be close enough. I guess what I could do instead is leave that. See if I can get this to work. So there's kind of this little band here. Yeah, so this gun here is it's a little bit of excess base tab. It's what I started with. I filed all of it down. Because for some reason I got it in my head that I should try and use some of that excess metal. And a base for a gun seemed like the most appropriate, or, you know, starting point for a gun. think any other work on this. I'm gonna need to just kind of wait on until after it dries. I might sand it a little bit. I might even try and reduce, even it up on some of the sides, but I think that works. That's kind of fun to actually leave that gap in there. So now, unfortunately, it doesn't really show up too well on yeah, that's why I shouldn't have done that. Don't really have a good way to grip this. My fingers in it, and it's kind of an inevitability. That's why I kind of want to get this. Maybe I should have done this last, but I was thinking. So I'll leave it at this, and then if I put my finger in it again, come back and clean it up after I've gotten the detail here. think what I might do next time is actually put just another small layer over this. That way I can get this part to be indented a little bit more. And I'll have a little bit of a frame around this detail there. The detail that I kind of just carved in. That means I will need to bulk this up a little bit, but that's not a big deal. And I think actually what I'm going to do is use a little bit of... I might shave this down a tiny bit. But I think I'm actually going to leave this as it is. I think it's coming along. Maybe not the straightest edge on those. But I feel like that's something I can clean up with some little bit of paint. Once I actually paint these guys. And won't be too noticeable. And I think hopefully, if I do it right, nobody will really take a second glance at it. But that's kind of what I got for today. Just some kind of quick detail. Some of that neck detail is going to be covered up with the shoulder strap here, so I'm not too worried about it. Got the other strap down here. I think I'll also need to... I'm just going to go ahead and put this guy's gun back in his hand for now. One of the other things I'm going to need to do is work on this shoulder. But that'll wait until I'm ready to keep them together. It actually looks like I'll probably need a detail. Maybe I won't need to do this detail, but I'll need to do this detail on this side here. But I might fudge that a little bit more than I did this time. And I'm going to go ahead and call it for the evening with just this. It's not as long a session, but I feel like I got some work done. And I'll go ahead and let this dry and work on them some more next week. Thank you all for joining, and you have a good evening.